I started this project in 2001, have been here since the beginning. In that time, I think we've done what is virtually the impossible.
The Broads is built on history, and I guess in 50, 60 years' time, this will be part of its history, which, you know, and hopefully somewhere in there, our names will be. Quite simply, the Broads, Norfolk and Suffolk Broads, are low-lying, and there is a real risk of flooding. So the Broadland project was to come in and to build a flood defence for the system so that it was able to cope with flood water.
If the defences weren't there in the first place, we'd actually be underwater at the moment. We'd be standing on the seabed and there'd be, you know, water as far as the eye could see.
In a place like this, it's quite kind of natural and wilderness-like. There's the natural habitats, but a lot of the Broads is made up of marshes and grazing marshes, so the livestock that are on there, that cattle on in the summer, and hay cuts and all of that is what some people in the Broads live on. So it's their livelihoods and businesses as well.
Jacobs and Bam Nuttall have done a lot of work that conventionally would have been done by the client. Getting down to it, it is a major engineering project in a national park.
A lot of the areas are under environmental designations, international ones, and a lot of them are sites of special scientific interest.
I think there's 20% of the rare species of the UK are found in the Broads. So things like water voles, otter. So we've got 28 species of dragonflies and damselflies here, which is the most in the UK. Right through some really rare species of birds that are associated with the Broads. It's even more important nowadays as well, especially with all of the COVID occurrence, you know, people getting out on in their local patches, in the countryside, and actually all to do with well-being as well. So it's not just about that lapwing or that marsh harrier or that dragonfly, it's actually about people's mental health stuff as well. So I think that's an important part of why places like nature reserves are really important.
Why are you still doing it after 20 years? You know, for me, the relationships with the people I work with are an important part of that. And it's surprising how many people have been involved in the project for the full term of the project, or most of it.
Fantastic project to work on. Work with some brilliant people. You know, many people have come and gone, but there's a core of us who are left right to the end, and we're the same people who met sort of 20 years ago in the first Norwich office and went some houses. It's been a lovely project to work on. Yeah.
The Broadland project has shown the advantage of undertaking long-term projects and the ability to do more than just the sum of the start of that project, and all the added benefits you get from developing long-term relationships with your client and your contractors and the stakeholders around you.
Yeah, the project has just finished. It's finished on time. It's finished to budget. You know, we're happy with the quality of work that's been done, and out there is a, you know, a satisfied sort of community with what we've done. So that's a sort of acid test.